So today we discuss about the redirection. One is first one is the 301. Second is the 302, 503, 403, and 404. Complete is the 5. Here, what is mean by redirection? Suppose just looking here. Just I'm typing for scoopit.com. What are you typing for? Listen carefully here. Just I'm entering for this one. So the website is not working. One second. Same URL. I'm searching for another browser. Okay. Scoopit.com. Now I'm entered. What is URL called? Scoop.it. What I'm entering for? Scoopit.com. So they redirect to the scoop.it. It is direct to the permanent redirection is called 301. Temporary redirection will be called 302. Suppose I'm creating for 5 pages website. I'm deleting one page, about us page. If anybody click about us, they redirect to the home page, is permanent redirection. That is called 301. 302 is the temporary redirection. 301 is the permanent redirection. One page to another page. 302 is the temporary redirection. One page to another page. 302 is the permanent. 302 is the temporary. Suppose how many pages are there here? Home, about us, DM training, offline market, everything. So if I click the home page, they open for the home page. Suppose if I click the offer, what is the open for the page called? Offer page. But when I open for the this offer page, they open for the about us page. Open for about us page. When you click the offer, they come into the about us page. Is a temporary call 302. Permanent call 301. So just here, I'm going to the click this one. What is called here? The link will be there. Just go to the Blogger dashboard. How to redirection permanent temporary on Blogger? How to redirection 301, 302 on Blogger? That is called permanent and temporary redirection. Now, what is goal will be called? When I click this offer, they go into the about us page or contact us page. Suppose I'm go to the Blogger dashboard. The option call is setting. The setting, the option call is search preference. What is called? Search preference. Now here, what is called here? Redirection. Now here, click this edit one. So here, all the redirection is there. So if you go with the permanent, this is called permanent. But I'm using only for temporary purpose. Now, please copy with along with the black slash, copy the URL from where it is will be going to the contact us. Yes or no? If anybody click this one, offer they go into the contact us now. Okay. If you click the permanent, what is called 301. Uncheck is a temporary. Now click save. Now click for save change. If anybody click the offer, they redirect to the contact us page. Now simply I'm click the home page. Now I'm click the offer page. So we're going here. So that is called redirection. Same that when we'll typing for scoopit.com. What is I'm entering for? Scoopit. Dot com. Redirect to the scoop.it. Only for your redirection purpose, using for 301 and 302. The page is removed unexpectedly. So we redirect to the home page. These all will be called redirections. Is it clear? This is called 301 and 302. Next will be called 403. 403 means website is live. Website is domain hosting is live, but website is no data. Website is no data. Now like this, the website will be live, but the website is no data. That is called 4R3 forbidden. That is called 4R3 forbidden. This replace I am published for the my website on my blog. In this website, I am replaced by the my blog address. My blog address will be called tollycinenews.blogspot.in. If anybody enter the tollycinenews.com, they open for the my blog. So now will be called 4R3. Yes or no? Yes or no? This is called 4R3. But if using for 301, 302 redirection, they will be called, when you enter in the my website name, they open for the my blog address. This will be done by the our cPanel. The website done by the cPanel. Our blog done by the in my blogger dashboard. Is it clear? We'll check here. How to will change for the our cPanel here. Simple here. This is my blog address. Okay. If what I'm entering for, when entering for tollycinenews.com, they relate to the my blog address. So this is my blog. So I'm going to dive into my cPanel. This is called cPanel. Select your domain. That is called add on domain here. Yes or no? This is called add a domain. What is called here? Redirects. Now click the redirects here. What is called here? 301 and 302. So here all public domain is available. Yes or no? See this. If anything is available here, they will show into the earth. So I am showing for temporary redirection. What is called temporary will be called 302. So here, what is the domain name? tollycinenews.com. Select here. Now here, redirect to my blog address. Only redirect with the double redirection. What is called is very important. Double redirection. Only read with the double or do not redirect for double without call redirectory. Wildcard. It's called wildcard entry. Now click for add. Then if anybody entering for the my website name, what is the domain name? tollycinenews.com. I've entered. Read to the my blog. The previous domain is live, but no data. That is called 4R3. Now I'm showing for when entering to the my domain name, tollycinenews.com. They read it to the my blog. Is it clear? This is called redirection and 4R3 forbidden. Is it clear? This is called about your information. Suppose what do you mean by 404? What do you mean by 404? Simple here, I'm entering for something here. What's showing here? Sorry, this page is not yet something like that. Showing. This is called 404 not found. Suppose here after domain, I'm entering for SHD. Yes or no? And click for enter. They relate to the home page. Yes or no? They relate to home page or not? See this here. You can build the profile. After profile.html, the way to the home page. This is called 404. If entering any kind of long URL structure, the way to the 404. The 404 will be mentioned for ST access. Mentioned for ST access. The code is available by the my blog. That is called rtsolutionshy.blogspot.in.st access. Please write down the code for ST access. Error document space 404 / index.html. The HTML call developer extension. Suppose you're using for website will be called PHP. You mentioned for .php. Suppose you mentioned for the ASPX, that is called .NET. You mentioned for index.axps. So website developing for which platform based on the extension will be available. Now my site designed by the HTML. Why? Because the website see this. I'm clicking for services. What is the extension here? HTML. Suppose if I'm click this section, this one, what is going on here? HTML website. Suppose you had to show them my website, Architect Solution. Here, no extension, but my design website called PHP. Is it clear? This is called, we can know how to check it out, simple results. Is it clear? This is called PHP website. Just go to the coding part, control U, search for PHP. In HTML site, don't use a PHP. If anybody asks, so in HTML site, how to find out the PHP? HTML site, don't use the PHP. The PHP they're using for HTML code, but HTML site, don't mind using for PHP code. It's very important notice. Is it clear? So this is called PHP. That time you can change for as PHP. This all will be called based on your domain extension. There will be has. Now click for save change. The code will be that if anything they entering after the URL, the read to the home page. Suppose the code is not there. The code is not there. What happened? We'll check here. So here I'm removing for htaccess file through using cPanel. Here what is saying for index.html. Here I'm entering for something. What's saying here? 404 file not found. The file is not updated. 404 file and the htaccess file is not updated. They will call as the 404 not found. File not found. Why? Because this file is not updated in my site. So they call it a error. Is it clear? This is called report and an update from the htaccess. About 404. Now I'm updating for the htaccess file. So what is that? After that, I'm entering for something. Related to the home page. This is called HTXS file. Error document space 404 / index.html. Save as .htaccess. The file document will be called .htaccess. The file name save as .htaccess. This is available code for our blog that is called artisolutionhy.blogspot.in. Is it clear? This is called 404 redirection code. That is called file not found code. Is it clear? This is called. Now, very important thing is a 503 redirection. What is that? 503 redirection. 503 redirection nothing but is their website under maintenance. Under maintenance. Somebody is going for scrolling, but is not open the site. This is called using for 503 code. What is called? 503 code. That is called service unavailable. DNS updating. Something is updating on your website. This is done by the developer. It's not your task. It's done by the developer. So simply the implementing code from here, the code will be implemented for your website. The website will be scrolling, but is not open. Why are you using for 503? If you are working on website, your keywords, is everything is at top one position. Suddenly website will be got down. Reason is a heavy traffic on your DNS issue. So if you have stopped the website 1 hour, 2 hours, enter keyword will be called loss. They will go into the second, third. Why? Because everyday traffic will become more than 1 lakh. But suppose you are working for 2 or 3 hours, your website is not working. What does it mean by your website coming to the down? Your keywords also down. That is called using for 503. So that time your website will be called scrolling, but is not open your website. This is called 503 redirection. This is about your code for service unavailable. They will be called scrolling. Is it clear? This is called redirection about your website using for 301, 302, 403, 404, 503.